In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Almighty God, unto whom all hearts be open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of thy Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love thee and worthily magnify thy holy name, through Christ our Lord. Pray, O God, the King of glory, who hast exalted thine only Son, Jesus Christ, with great triumph unto thy kingdom in heaven, we beseech thee, leave us not comfortless, but send to us thine Holy Ghost to comfort us, and exalt us unto the same place whither our Saviour Christ is gone before, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Ghost, one God, world without end.
A reading from this epistle of St. Paul's to the Romans. If God is for us, who is against us? He that spared not his own Son, but delivered him up for us all, how shall he not also with him freely give us all things? Who shall lay anything to the charge of God's elect? It is God that justifies. Who is he that shall condemn? It is Christ Jesus that died, yea, rather, that was raised from the dead, who is at the right hand of God, who also maketh intercession for us. Who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or anguish, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or peril, or sword? Even as it is written, for thy sake we are killed all the day long. We are counted as sheep for the slaughter. Nay, in all these things we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. For I am persuaded that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. This is the word of the Lord.
Holy Gospel according to John. Glory to you. Comforter is come, whom I shall send unto you from the Father, even the Spirit of truth, which proceedeth from the Father, he shall testify of me, and ye also shall bear witness, because ye have been with me from the beginning. These things have I spoken unto you, that you should not be offended. Then they shall put you out of the synagogues. Yea, the time cometh that whosoever killeth you will think that he doeth God service. And these things will they do unto you, because they have not known the Father nor me. But these things have I told you, that when the time shall come, ye may remember that I told you of them.
Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. The gospel stories of the resurrection are, funnily enough, initially not quite as triumphant and indisputable as you might imagine. Things aren't clear initially. People aren't recognizable. Mary thought Jesus might be the gardener. These are stories about surprise and disorientation. Surprise and disorientation brought about as the friends of Jesus discover he's not dead. He's not a body under a memorial slab. His life, his earthly life, body and mind, has become the channel by which God goes on speaking to the world, the way in which God is with us, committed to us, whatever we do. In the forceful phrase of a modern French writer, the resurrection has tipped Jesus over into the transcendence of God. But because the risen Jesus is still a recognizable human being, that doesn't mean that Jesus has abandoned the world he belongs to, our world, still his world. He is the sign and the power of God's freedom at work in and through the limitations, the tragedies, the frustrations of the world of human beings. In every pang that rents the heart, the man of sorrows has a part. The resurrection is about God's commitment to this world of flesh and blood. It tells us that when we look at things and persons in the world and situations, we're looking at the place where God has promised to be. And they're not always pleasant places. It's the light that gives us a way of seeing everything. In the Easter stories, it's Jesus that has his friends looking. It is Jesus that his friends are conscious of. the center, the heart of the bewildering new world they have to now adapt to. But after a while, there are no more reports of people seeing Jesus as at first. The light has ceased to be something that has drawn our attention in its own right. It's now something we see by. At the Ascension, it's the moment when Jesus goes away, Father Tony preached on Thursday, stops being an object we concentrate on in itself, and yet it's at that moment that God becomes more and more deeply and permanently present to us in Christ. I am with you always to the end of the time. He is with us as the light we now see by. We see the world in a new way because we see it through him, see it with his eyes. So it's not only that we know that the world is a place where God has promised to be, if we see it in the light of Jesus, because Jesus has become the very sight of our own eyes, we see it as a place to which we too are committed. Our faith is not an escape hatch. It is a plunging into the very reality that God is committed to. Jesus raised from the dead is the great sign of God's faithfulness to the world. And we come to share in that same faithfulness. We are caught up in the eternal movement of God's commitment to his creation. The light is on, the morning has come, the day star from on high has dawned upon us. And so indeed, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation or anguish or peril or sword? Nay, in all these things, we are more than conquerors through him that loved us. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and of all things visible and invisible, and in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, begotten of his Father. Light of light, very
Let us pray for the whole state of Christ's Church and for all according to their needs.
Almighty God, who has taught us to pray for all men and has promised to hear the prayers of those who ask in faith, we beseech thee to look mercifully upon thy universal Church and to inspire it with a spirit of truth, unity, and concord. We pray especially for the work of the Church in this diocese and ask thy blessing on Tabe, our bishop, and Joshua, his suffragan. Lord, in thy mercy.
Amen.
We pray for the needs of those who live in this place and worship in this church. And we give thanks today, Lord, for our clergy. Thank you for the wholehearted care, love, and genuine interest in us all, shown day by day, day after day by Father Timothy and Father Tony. Thank you for the privilege of how, through them, we experience your presence in the sacraments each week. Give both our rector and Father Tony your unending support and grace. Lord, in thy mercy.
Amen.
We pray for a right stewardship of the world thou hast created. We pray for the nations of the world and for their leaders, that they may minister justice for the maintenance of righteousness and peace. At this time, we pray for peace throughout the world. We pray, Lord, on this Anglican Communion Sunday, for the Anglican Communion throughout the world, and for its work in attempting to proclaim your gospel and to do your will. We pray for those elected to public office, both in our own land and throughout our continent, as we say, God bless Africa.
God help our children. Guide her leaders and give her peace, for Jesus Christ's sake. Amen.
We beseech thee to bless both whom we love and those for whom we are bound to pray. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We beseech thee of thy goodness to send thy healing grace to all who suffer in body or in soul, especially for Barbara Gwynosis, Rian van Wyk, Tanya Jordan, Sarah Babu, Caroline Bagri, Judy Veli, and Jacqueline de Villiers. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
We commend to thy gracious keeping all those who have died in faith, especially we pray for those whose years, minds occur this week, and for the repose of the soul of Leon Joint, Jacobus Mostert, William Dyson, Eric Lowe, Sherry Kelly, Edward Wilson, George Jonathan Priest, Aaron Lappitz, Irene Copeland, Mary Forbes, Elizabeth O'Day, Mary Gomes, Dorothy Kanemeyer, Barry Hodgson, priest and former rector, Caroline Fick, Daisy Peake, Mildred Espen, and Tom O'Connor. Rest eternal grant unto them, O Lord, and that light perpetual shine upon them. We pray for those who will die in our country today, especially those who will die alone and unloved. Lord, in thy mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Merciful Father, grant these our prayers for Jesus Christ's sake, our only mediator and advocate.
To prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries, let us humbly confess our sins to Almighty God. We confess,
God Almighty, Father, Son,
word and deed to our own fault. Wherefore we pray God to have mercy upon us. Almighty God, have mercy upon you, forgive you all your sins, deliver you from all evil, confirm and strengthen you in all goodness, and bring you unto everlasting life through Jesus Christ our Lord.
10 o'clock, and the reminder of Evensong and Benedict. Thank you.
give thanks unto the Lord God.
It is meet and right, so true.
It is very meet, right, and our bounden duty that we should at all times and in all places give thanks unto thee, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Everlasting God, through thy most dearly beloved Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who after his most glorious resurrection manifestly appeared to all his apostles, and in their sight ascended up into heaven to prepare a place for us, that where he is, thither we might also ascend and reign with him in glory. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify thy glorious name, evermore praising thee and saying, and thanksgiving be to thee, Almighty God, our Heavenly Father, for that thou of thy tender mercy didst give thine only Son, Jesus Christ, to take our nature upon him, and to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who, by his one oblation of himself once offered, made a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world, and an institute and in his holy gospel command us to continue a perpetual memory of that his precious death until his coming again. Hear us, O merciful Father, we most humbly beseech thee, and grant that we, receiving these thy creatures of bread and wine, according to thy Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood, who, in the same night that he was betrayed, took bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." Likewise, after supper, he took the cup, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink ye all of this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many, for the remission of sins. Do this as oft as ye shall drink it, in remembrance." Therefore, O Lord and Heavenly Father, according to the institution of thy dearly beloved Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. We, thy humble servants, having in remembrance his blessed passion and precious death, his mighty resurrection and glorious ascension, to render unto thee most hearty thanks for the innumerable benefits procured unto us by the same. And, looking for his coming again with power and great glory, we offer here unto thy divine majesty this holy bread of eternal life and this cup of everlasting salvation. And we humbly beseech thee to pour thy Holy Spirit upon us and upon these thy gifts, that all we who are partakers of this holy communion may worthily receive the most precious body and blood of thy Son, and be filled with thy grace and heavenly benediction. And we entirely desire thy fatherly goodness mercifully to accept this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. We most humbly beseeching thee to grant that by the merits and death of thy Son, Jesus Christ, and through faith in his blood, we in all thy whole church may obtain remission of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. And here we often present unto thee, O Lord, ourselves, our souls and bodies, to be a reasonable, holy, and living sacrifice unto thee. And although we be unworthy through our manifold sins to offer unto thee any sacrifice, yet we beseech thee to accept this our bounden duty and service, not weighing our merits, but pardoning our offenses through Jesus Christ our Lord. By whom and with whom, in the unity of the Holy Ghost, all honor and glory be unto thee, O Father Almighty, world without end. As our Saviour Jesus Christ hath commanded and taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive them that trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, I leave you peace, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and grant us the peace and unity of your kingdom, where you live forever and ever. Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with our spirits.
Presume to come to this thy table, O merciful Lord, trusting in our own righteousness, but in thy manifold and great mercies. We are not worthy to touch together at the crown of thy table. Thou art the same Lord, whose property is always to have mercy. Grant us, therefore, gracious Lord,
This is the Lamb of God that taketh away the sins of the world. Happy are those who are called to his Son.
Lord,
thank you.
O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is gracious. Let us pray. Look with favor, most holy Trinity, on this our act of worship and service, and may the sacrifice set forth before thine eyes be acceptable to thy divine majesty, and avail for us and all for whom we have offered it, who livest and reignest, one God, world without end.
Mass is ended. Go in peace.
And be glad, O Virgin Mary, Alleluia. O God, who by the resurrection of thy Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, has given joy unto the whole world, grant, we beseech thee, that through his mother, the Virgin Mary, we may obtain the joys of life eternal through the same Jesus Christ our Lord.